English, it's not just about reading and writing. There's all kinds of things that we want you to be able to do when you take high school English. Those of you coming into grade 9, you'll be put into Language Arts 9. And then it's up to you what level of English is appropriate for you. So we have 10-1, 10-2, 20-1, 20-2, 30-1, and 30-2. So really the difference is, what are you going to do after high school? If you want to keep your doors open, then you want to keep that -1 program in mind. That's where we study Shakespeare, modern plays, poetry, short stories, pretty much any type of genre is available to your English teachers. -2 students, your focus will be similar genres. No Shakespeare though, and you'll be looking at modern plays. We're all trying to get you to encourage you to love literature and really work on your communication skills, because after all, literacy is important.
Get out of the desk!
And onto the stage.
English Drama Combined
encourages you
to take part in the action.
Bringing the best of both worlds into one cooperative team talk class. So, what are some of the things you like to do in English class?
We read Shakespeare.
That's great. If you take English Drama Combined, we'll put on a full-length Shakespearean production. A comedy, though, not a tragedy.
We do a lot of writing, creative, analytical. Do you do any of that in drama?
We adapt for the stage. We write scripts and screenplays.
Awesome. We study film.
Well, in the English Drama Combined, we can do an acting for the camera unit.
We work really hard on oral communications, debates, speeches, presentations.
It's all drama.
Enjoy the flexibility
of a combined course.
You can get English 10-1 or 20-1.
And you can get Drama 10 or Drama 20 or Drama 30, depending where you're coming at us from.
Wait, I can get English 20-1 and Drama 10?
You could. If you didn't take drama in grade 10, here's your chance to get those Drama 10 credits. But if you've taken it, you can take English 20-1 and Drama 20. If you've taken 10 and 20, you can take English 10 or 20-1 or Drama 10, Drama 20, or Drama 30. It's going to be awesome. Get involved.
I'm Mrs. Latosky, and I approve this message.
Okay, by working hard in social studies class, you can learn how to rule the world. You'll learn how to exploit the workers.
Your class is a dictatorship, a self-perpetuating autocracy in which the working classes are—
Quiet, Maverick.
That's what it's all about. If only people would—
Please, Maverick, I'm trying to make a video about how everyone has to take social studies to graduate. In the future, they can take -1 or -2, it doesn't matter, but they have to take it to graduate.
Students in your class should be learning about anarcho-syndicist commune.
Be quiet!
They should be learning about the general will of the people.
I said be quiet!
And how a simple democracy can make decisions in internal affairs.
I said be quiet!
And by two-thirds—
I order you be quiet!
Oh, you can't expect to wield supreme executive power because you're the teacher.
Will you shut up? Will you just shut up?
And now we see the violence inherent in the system.
Come on.
Oh, come! Come see the violence inherent in the system! Help! I'm being repressed!
You have to take social studies, is the moral of the story.
Hi guys, Mrs. Cleavegard here to tell you all about math. One thing you need to know about William E. Hay, when you're here, everything is free. So make use of it. This is the only building in the world where everybody wants you to succeed. When you get out in the real world, everyone will be in competition with you. So, go for it. What do you need for math? You need grade 11 math as a minimum to graduate from high school in Alberta. So make sure you have credits in grade 10 and grade 11. Those of you in math 9-3 will automatically register in math 10-3. Anyone who passes math 9 can register in math 10C. After that, the choice is yours. You need to check the course offerings booklet and check all the pathways that you can go to. You need to check post-secondary requirements and see what they need for math. And after that, the choice is yours. If you have any questions, come and talk to any of the math teachers. We'd be glad to help you. See you in math.
Well, I'm Mr. Siemens. I'd like to just take a couple moments to tell you about our science program here at the high school. Almost all our students take grade 9 science to start with, and then when they go into grade 10 science, they have a couple different options. They can take science 10, or they can choose to take science 14. If you take science 10 and pass it, you then have the option of taking bio, chemistry, physics, or also general science at the science 20 and 30 level in the future. You need a science at the 20 level in order to graduate and get an Alberta high school diploma.
In Bio 20, you study things like the heart and the lungs. You also study a little bit of environment and evolution. In Bio 30, you would study about the brain and reproduction. You also study about genetics and that sort of thing. Bio 2030 would be an awesome class for grade 11 or grade 12 students to take. If a grade 11 student is thinking about taking Bio 30 eventually, and they maybe want to get one of their diploma courses out of the way in grade 11, this would be a good course for you. The way it will be structured is as separate class, in that you will be taking Bio 20 for the first half of the semester, and then we'll move on to Bio 30 for the second half of the semester.
And chemistry teaches you why objects are the way they are, and I think that's a really neat thing. You get to figure out why certain substances have certain properties, to figure out why some things dissolve and why some things don't. You get to figure out why some things burn and how they do it, and lots of neat stuff like that. The Chem 2030 students, and there's always two classes of those a year, and there's always like three extra Chem 20 classes, so we end up having a lot of Chem kids.
Hi, I'm Mr. Bear, and I'm here to talk to you today about Physics 20. In our class, we do lots of labs. During Project Week, we do Science Fair, where you build your own project and present it. We also go to West Edmonton Mall for a field trip and have lots of fun! Please take my class.
Take personal psychology or general psychology and see if there might be something wrong with me or you. Could be the way you're looking at the world, not me.
Digital photography is a hands-on course where we talk about, obviously, photography, but beyond that we learn editing, we work in Photoshop, we learn how to fix and enhance pictures. Some examples we do would be moving around parts of a picture, doing digital makeup, fixing blemishes, restoring old photos, projects like that. It's a very useful course, and that is something you could actually make use of as you get older, when you have children, have a family, things like that, and you will learn a lot. We also get to play with SLR cameras, learn composition, go on field trips, and do a variety of photography.
Okay, you can take Art 9, Art 10, Art 20, Art 30, and as well in Art 9 you can take a crafts class. In these classes you can learn everything from perspective to shading, you learn about color theory, tone, you learn about different styles of art and learn how to express yourself creatively. In crafts class as well you learn how to be creative in different ways. It's a very fun class, and I encourage you to come take a look at it and enjoy it.
Whoosh!
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 Whoosh! Wow! Whoosh!
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 Hi, I'm Mr. Fleischack, and I teach drama at William E. Hay. Whoosh! Whoosh!
Whoosh!
You can learn about yourself and others through participation with drama.
Wow!
You can learn how to enhance your communication skills through dramatic activities.
Whoosh!
And you can learn to love both drama and theater.
Whoosh! Whoosh!
Well, what's the difference between drama and theater?
Whoosh!
Whoosh!
Whoosh! Theater has an audience. Whoosh!
Whoosh!
But what if you want to learn more about theater?
Whoosh!
Whoosh!
Then you can sign up for Theater Arts, the extracurricular class at William E. Hay, where you can get credits for doing what you love to do. Get involved with our extracurricular full big productions.
Get involved with the fine arts at William E. Hay.
If you get involved in the Theater Arts program at William E. Hay, you can be involved on stage in our production work or behind the scenes. You can get involved in doing sound and lights for our shows. You can be a stage manager, you can be a costume master. The opportunities are fantastic and endless. Get involved in Theater Arts at William E. Hay.
Hello, I'm Miss Rhonda, and I'm the dance teacher of the Dance 15, 25, 35 program here at William E. Hay. I want to welcome you to come and join us for some dance fun. We explore all genres of dance, from ballet, modern, contemporary, hip-hop, musical theater, jazz, tap. We also do some nutritional things and some other production sort of things along the way. It really doesn't matter if you've been a dancer all your life or if it's just something you've really wanted to try. We welcome everyone.
Hi there. Welcome to the band room. Well, it's quiet now. Normally it's very noisy. We have grade 9 band all the way up to grade 12. It actually starts in grade 6, but I won't bore you with that because you're now in high school. Grade 9 program is offered both semesters, and it's during school time. Grade 10, 11, 12 band is a 5-credit course. Five, count them. 5 credits. All I have to do is come twice a week on Wednesdays and Friday mornings, and we make awesome music. I'm not a morning guy, but we make it work. There is a coffee machine over there. That always helps. It's just a great way to get 5 credits. If you're musically inclined, it's actually quite an easy way to get 5 credits as well. So look forward to seeing you here, and I'll try not to be too noisy next to your library.
I was lucky enough this year to get chosen to teach fashion studies as well. And I plan to delve into the world of haute couture and to teach not only sewing basics, how to follow a pattern, but also to look into European fashions and styles, look into doing fashion shows, helping with the fashion show with the cosmetology kids this year. And honestly, we're going to have a great time. It's going to be a lot of hands-on work. We're going to have a lot of fun. And so come out and join fashion studies with me. Thanks.
So, si vous êtes Canadien et vous voulez apprendre comment est-ce qu'on parle en français, c'est avec moi. Welcome to William E. Hay, and if you want to learn how to speak our second official language, then come take French. You can take French 10-3Y. That takes to 20-3Y, and then by French 30-3Y, believe it or not, I'm teaching in French, and you're speaking in French, and it's all fantastique. French 9, those of you coming into French 9, please make sure that you have Francais 7 and Francais 8. Those are 2 prerequisites for this class. So I hope to see you in my French class. Au revoir.
Nous sommes Canadiens.
Guten Morgen. Ich heiße Herr Fleischacker. Ich bin Lehrer am William E. Hay. Wissen Sie was? Sie können Deutsch lernen beim William E. Hay. Sie können Deutsch 10 nehmen nächstes Jahr. Sie können Schnee-Schnapp-Schnappi lernen.
Ich bin Schnappi, das kleine Krokodil.
Kokodil!
Aus Ägypten, das liegt direkt am Nil. Zuerst lag ich in einem Ei.
Ei.
Dann Schnee-Schnapp-Schnapp, ich bin frei.
Well, Math Enhancement is a course that you take in addition to your regular math class. At the present time, you get your credits through a program called Learning Strategies, and through that program, we hope to teach you organization and some time management skills. And we also hope to be able to have you assess your strengths and weaknesses in math. The classes are usually very small, so there's lots of time for one-on-one help. And sometimes there's even homemade cookies to brighten your day.
Hi, I'm Mrs. Latosky. I'm teaching Literacy Enhancement this year. This course is intended for students coming into grade 9 who are struggling with reading comprehension or need some help with some writing strategies. We do a lot of practice, we have a lot of fun, we do some reading, and you get to improve your language arts mark.
We
Would you know what to do in this kind of a situation? If not, consider taking a course in sports medicine. You can take a look at sports nutrition, you can take a look at your athletic injury management, as well as get certified in first aid. This way you can be an asset to your team.
Healthcare Aid will be offered again next spring with a February beginning of the course. We have a partnership with Bow Valley College, and students will do part-time at the high school and then part-time at Campus Albertus in Statler here. While they're at the high school, they'll be working on module work from Bow Valley College, and then what they do is they'll earn credits, high school CTS credits. At the end of the 16-week program, they will have completed their healthcare aid certification, which is the minimum requirement for working in the healthcare industry in Alberta. The 16 weeks consist of approximately 11 weeks of classroom work where they're doing module stuff, and then they do approximately 5 weeks split between 3 weeks of clinical work and then 2 weeks of preceptorship. So you're actually out in the industry working hands-on in the field. This is an awesome program for students who are thinking about maybe going into the medical industry, as you have increased earning power while you're going to post-secondary. And any student who wants to get into the medical industry but maybe doesn't have the marks to get into nursing, this is a great entrance program for you.
Meetings, do it online or both.
IncomeAtHome.com. Freedom.
Are we gonna start with college or start our career?
School's pretty important, so I think we should go to college first. Skip the rest, or the beginning.
Okay, I think it'll get us a better job.
Yeah. Especially at the Krusty Krab, eh? So I got...
Wait, shouldn't we start here?
Adopt a pet.
You're gonna adopt a pet.
I get to adopt a pet? Oh, I hope I get Gary's snail.
Wait. I think that we need to make sure that it's within your budget to get a pet.
Oh.
Guys, maybe we should have taken career money management from Mrs. Nealon.
That's a good idea that we should have done.
Alicia, why do you love ComTech?
I hate it.
T-Swift and T-Pain rapping on the same track. It's a thug story, tell me, can you handle that?
I love you!
Pop quiz, what's my favorite color?
Babe, I miss you.
Shines a bright blue sky.
Alright, Tommy, you're the oldest. I'm counting on you. Come on.
He's got eyes on the bluest skies as if they.
Of hot dogs that you can buy. You can buy these cheap ones, larger packs, but they're small, cheap little wieners, not really that good. Or you can buy these nice, long, thick, much larger wieners.
Hey! ELOs, or extended learning opportunities, allow you, the student, to complete a special project in a field that interests you. It has to be a subject that isn't offered at our school or something that goes beyond what you would normally learn in a high school environment. It's a very rigorous process in which you do independent learning, so you need to be a motivated, self-directed learner. And you also need special permission from myself or administration in order to do an ELO. So if you're interested, please see me for more information. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Miss Nealon, and I teach cosmetology here at the high school. Cosmetology! Everybody loves cosmetology. Almost everybody loves cosmetology. Most of the grade 9 girls come into our school, go into cos, and it is so much fun. If you like getting your nails done, if you like getting your hair done, if you like getting your makeup done, if you like working with other people, if you like braiding hair and entering competitions and getting free stuff and having a really good time doing it, this is the place to be. You learn practical skills about personal hygiene, everything from personal hygiene to doing gel nails. Basically, if you've heard of it in the industry, we do it here. And I know that I've got a lot of people that love what we're doing, and we hope to keep doing it, so come on, be one of us.
We love cars! We love cars!
Finally, computer design revolves around MasterCam, which we've been using for the last 10 years, and it is directly associated with our CNC router table, which is a 4x8 table. So the idea is that you are programming things you want to build or cut. The computer design hooks into the trade of the machinist, because you do take the MasterCam design training in your third year of being a machinist. The last point I'd like to make about computer design is what a nice marriage it is between woodwork. If we have students that are interested in carpentry, can also learn how to program our CNC router, and it makes for a really different approach to building your cabinet. One ensures that you get the three modules you need for any future courses in grade 11 or 12. So that's really the best place to start. Grade 11, you might run into 2.1, which is a framing course. So you're going to learn basic framing. Also, the products extend to the customers as well. By grade 11 and 12, you're mostly going to be working on either particular projects I want you to learn from or customer projects. Everything goes to advanced classes in 3.1 and 3.2, which you would take in grade 12. A lot more independent work that I come around and supervise, but I've got you to the point now where you could probably lay out walls, hang doors, install windows, build a basic cabinet without a lot of input from me, but I do keep an eye on you. I'm here to speak about the Industrial Arts Grade 9 program that we've had in our shops for many years. Generally, it depends on who's teaching the particular groups every term. I've had, for the last two semesters, I've had grade 9s, and I've been taking them mostly through the wood shop and learning about skills and tools in there, and then combining it with some computer design. But all three of us make sure that safety is the main concern, getting students orientated to the tools that they may or may not have used before, and establishing safety concerns and safe practices is really what it's all about.
You want to be the best housewife, right? Step one is the proper attire. You're never a good housewife without your apron. Yeah, that one, over there. Now for step two, make sure you always have fresh cookies for your husband. Off to the kitchen.
You gonna come to my class?
Sure.
Okay, that's good. Now you're going to be a great cook after you take my class. Because we're going to be slowly molding you, just like molding a bread, okay? We're going to ask you to learn to using some ingredient, right? And using some stove, ovens, put the stuff together, right?
Right.
So that's what we're going to do, right? This is our 101.
What's the goal of work experience?
I'd say to provide students with an opportunity to experience work, earn credits at the same time, and there's 25 hours of work required for each credit.
So a decent amount.
Yeah.
Why was work experience implemented?
I think for both the students and the community, the students to be able to earn credits, I guess a wage on the side as well, and the community to be able to train students the way they want, so when they do enter the work world, they're ready to go.
What's the Green Certificate?
Green Certificate is a farm apprenticeship program. So there's different groups. There's cow-calf, equine, dairy, sheep, beekeeping, irrigated crop and field, feedlot, swine. So there's all different groups, and there's modules that you have to work through, work experience again on the farm, doing whichever one you choose. They have the same type of idea. You can earn up to 16 credits with the green certificate.
And what's RAP?
RAP is the Registered Apprenticeship Program. So typically how we do it in our school is you have to have work experience first with that employer. You would need 125 hours just because it is a relationship between the student, the school, the government actually, as well as the employer. So you would have 125 hours of work experience. Then altogether you'd decide whether it was something you wanted to pursue as an apprenticeship program, and we'd do up your paperwork and get you going.
Welcome to the automotive shop. This is the shop where you learn about your cars, trucks, quads, snowmobiles, anything that's motorized. If you're interested in mechanical things, this is the place to go. Come see. Let's go for a walk. For the advanced classes, we work on engines and cars that come that nobody else wants to play with. And this one had multiple problems, but the students figured it out. Charger proper, you learn how to use a tire machine proper, a balancing machine proper, then you'll be installing and removing tires off vehicles. And if you were to buy an engine out of the factory, a crated engine, you're looking at about $7,000. Whereas if you can take an engine apart yourself and you know how to use the equipment, put the tools back together again, you could probably build a complete engine that you want specific for your machine with the power it has, like a diesel here. You could build that machine and save yourself 3/4 of what a new crated engine would cost. So in the auto shop, we get to learn how this big mess on the floor here of all bits and pieces, how it all goes back together in the engine.
I am Ryan Garbett, and I am here with Mr. Ho. Mr. Ho, what do you think about fabrication?
You mean welding?
I mean welding.
Oh, welding's not bad, and I think that we need some of those guys, because we need them to weld the building, you know, get the building together. But I think so, but I think that food's better, though.
What does the fox say about fabrication?
Well, I think fabrication is an awesome opportunity to learn about the welding trade.
Yeah, okay.
Hey,
David, what do you think about Fab Class?
Fab is fab.
Never fear, Writers Club is here!
But it's so blank.
Be the change helps make a difference in the world. If you want to be like Mahatma Gandhi and be the change you want to see in the world, join Be the Change.
Okay, let's go.
Okay.
Gonna make a change. No way. You are Be the Change.
Do you like reading good books? Do you like talking about books?
Join Book Club!
We meet every 2 weeks in my classroom.
I like words.
Improv! So, Meg, what do we do at improv?
Basically, improv is acting without a script, so most of us don't know what we're doing until the moment we're doing it. Well, this year, me and Maggie, co-captains of the improv team, decided that we wanted to become a competitive team. So we went to a competition. You compete against other improvers from other schools. You don't have to worry about what other people are thinking of you, because they don't know what they're thinking themselves. And it is what it is. It's just kind of an overall good time. And just lots of games and fun.
Go to improv.
Yeah. School Reach is a trivia-based game based on the TV show Reach for the Top. And we practice once a week from about November till March or April. And we go to 3 competitions, in one here and 2 in Pinoca. They just answer trivia questions with a buzzer system. It's lots of fun.
Video Game League.
Video Game League is a competitive league where we have people in teams of 4 competing in a variety of video games, whether it's racing, sports, which I don't think we're ever going to do again, fighting games, etc. They earn points for their team. We tally it throughout the year. There's going to be a prize at the end.
We do lots of cool things inside. We plan lots of events, do lots of cool things. I don't know, last year we had a wake-a-thon. Cool things like that. We try and do different things every year, but our main goal is we're trying to better today's society and stop drinking and driving. It's a big problem in today's youth, and we like to think that we have some toll on that opinion. So come hang out with us. Sometimes we eat Timbits and cool stuff.
The Gay Straight Alliance was created to help promote equality and awareness within our school. We support students of sexual minorities and their allies as we hold weekly meetings and school-wide events. You can learn more about the LGBT community around the world and the difficulties they face, as well as how you can advocate equality. We believe that love should be a human right.
Join us next year!
Woo!
Yay,
I've got an eyelash in my...
Well, basically in our outdoor ed program, we go on 2 trips during the year. We go on one kind of smaller trip in the fall and then one longer trip in the spring. And the idea is we want to get students in the outdoors and learn how to enjoy the outdoors safely and have fun and have a great time. The neat thing about this club is actually if you go on these trips and you do kind of the work required, you actually get school credits when you do these trips. The big thing is safety. You know, we want students to be able to work with axes and knives in the outdoors and do it safely. And so we teach them how to use a hatchet, how to use a knife, how to build fires, how to cook, so that they, when they go and do these things on their own time for fun, they know how to do these things well and they'll actually come back in one piece.